Hello and welcome in this video of the contour lines. In this video we are going to understand about the contour lines, the contour intervals and the contour index. So everything, the whole topic we are going to discuss in this video. So in this video we will discuss about the contour lines, the contour interval and the contour index. So if we talk about the contour lines means the elevated area. Whenever we are highlighting the elevated area on the map, it will be treated as a contour lines. Now this is the 2D image of a picture. This is a 2D image. As you know that the globe is a 3D image, and this is the picture. This is the picture of a mountain. So it is a 2D image. Now if we try to put the same thing on the map, suppose if we are trying to put the same thing on the map, so how to show the elevated area on the map? If you draw the same thing, it will be treated as an image. So the map will be seen from the top. So if anybody is watching the map, it is a kind of a draw. If you are drawing this, the elevated area, it can also be treated as a road or a canal. So the map is an attempt to show the elevated area or the loads by certain symbols. So, and that is why we use the contour lines. We use the contour lines in order to show the elevated area on the map. Suppose in the map you have seen that, suppose the height of this area is 500 meter. The contour line is always indicated with a meter. Suppose the height of this area is 500 meter. Again, the another height I am going to show, it is the 400 meter. It is a 400 meter elevated area. Again, there is another height. It is called the 300 meter. It is the elevated area of the 300 meter. And again, the another height is also there. It will be called the 200 meter. So the different height I am highlighting, it will be treated as a contour line, because this line belongs to the same height of the area. So height of the area we indicate with the contour lines. Now suppose this is a mountain, and here I am making the map of this mountain with the contour lines. So here it is an elevated area. Now this is the another height. I am going to highlight it with the contour line. It is a height, and it is also an another contour line. It is also an another contour line. So this elevated area from here up to the here, it will be treated as a vertical contour, as a vertical height. The vertical height, it will be called the vertical height. And here suppose the height of this place is 200 meter. Suppose it is 200 meter, and this suppose 150 meter, and here it is 100 meter, and here it is again the 50 meter. So how will I represent it with the contour line? So here if I make a map, it will be a 200 meter here. It will be a 200 meter. Again, this will be of 150 meter, and once again it will be 100 meter. So this is the way how to highlight any mountain on the map with the contour lines. So here again with the 50 meter. So this one I am highlighting with the 50 meter, with the 50 meter. So this is the place, it is called the contour interval, the difference. Now another thing, this is the steep part, this is the steep slope, and here is the gentle slope. You can watch over here, it is called the gentle slope. And this area is called the steep, and this area is called the gentle. Now on the steep floor, the distance would be less between two contour lines. The difference would be less if the area if the mountain is a steep one, and here the difference would be larger if the area is a gentle one. Now, if the distance, if the contour interval is the maximum, if the contour interval is more, it means it is a gentle area. If the contour interval is less, it means it is a steep area. So I hope that this is clear for everyone. So this line would be treated as a contour line, because this whole area, whichever I am highlighting with the line, belongs to the same elevated area. The height of this area is similar in all the places in which I am highlighting with the line. And another one, the difference between the two line indicate the gentle slope. If the difference between the two line is less, it will be called a steep slope, and it will be called a contour interval. So I hope that the contour interval and the contour line is clear for everyone. Now, if we try to see this picture, this is the mountain and this is the 2D map picture. This is a picture of the 2D map. It is an image and it is a 2D map. Now here you can see the distance is larger and the distance is smaller, the same thing which I said just now, because this area is a steep and this area is gentle, and that is why there is a difference of the gap, because this area is here, I am highlighting, this area has much less gap and this area has more gap. It means it is a gentle and it is a steep slope. Now this is the vertical. Now index contour. What is the meaning of index contour? If the map is a standard one, if you see a map of the standard map, the difference is between the 2 meter. Of every 2 meter, I have to make a contour. Every 2 meter. Now here, in another one, whatever the index, the contour I have made, I have not followed the 2 meter. So it is not a standard map. I have made the map according to my own wish. But if I am making a standard map, then at every distance of 20 meter, I have to make a contour. So it will be called a index contour. So I hope that the contour interval and the contour index is clear for everyone. So this is called at the apex of the mountain. So this is called the vertical interval, and here it is called the horizontal interval. It is called the horizontal interval, and this is called the vertical one. It is called the vertical interval on the image of the mountain. So I hope that this is clear for everyone. Now it is called the conical hill. The conical hill means it is not the steep, or either it is not steep on one side and the gentle on the other side. The vertical height of the mountain in both of the sides are equal. No side is steep and another side is gentle. If it is gentle, it is in the both side, and if it is steep, then it is in the both side. So that kind of hill is called the conical hill. Now here, if you can see this hill, it is in the same steep. The steep of the mountain is similar in both the sides. Now it is the elevated area of 600 meter, and another one is again the elevated area of the 500 meter. It is called the contour index. It is called the contour index. And another one is the 400 elevated area, 400 meter, again 300 meter, and again the 200 meter. And the last one is the 100 meter. So it is the elevated area. Now the distance between the interval distance is also the same, because the steepness of the hill is equal in both the sides. So such kind of hill is called the conical hill. So I hope that the conical hill, it is a clear image of the conical hill. So I hope that the conical hill is clear for everyone. Now see this, it is a survey sheet. Now in the survey sheet, if how the question will come in the exam, the question will come in the exam as Now, how a question will come? The question will come is find out a contour index in this area. Now, in this area, you can see here it is a contour index. The line which I am highlighting, the 280 is a counter index here in this 17, 18, the 17, 18 square. The counter index is 280. So this kind of question will appear in the board examination. So thanks for watching this video. Thank you.